start with a new chapter, Anatomy of Flowering Plants. We have already done Physiology of Flowering Plants. Now we'll take up a new chapter, Anatomy of Flowering Plants. Why I have taken up this chapter is, the reason being, now you've got your unit test, so maybe you won't get sufficient time in the evening for revisions. So let's do a chapter which is simple and which a little bit you already know about in class 9th and 10th, you have done a little about it. That is the reason we picked up this chapter, Anatomy of Flowering Plants. See, very simple, when we start defining what is a tissue. All of you know what is a tissue. They are a group of cells which have a common origin and come together to perform the same function. So what are the characteristics when we talk about tissues? Tissue is not one cell, most important thing. Tissue is a group of cells. Second thing which we all need to remember about tissues is that they have a common origin. Okay? And the third is, they perform the same function. Plant bodies, they have different types of tissues. So many types of tissues. But broadly, we classify the plant tissues into two categories, meristematic tissue and permanent tissues. We've got many types of tissues in a plant body, but broadly, we categorize all the plant tissues into two categories. They are meristematic tissues and permanent tissues. So in this video, as of now, I'll just be taking meristematic tissues with you. When we say meristematic tissues, these are similar. When we talk about the growth in plants, all the parts of a plant do not grow. This we know. Growth in plants is restricted to special regions. Only special areas or special regions can continuously grow in a plant. Such areas or such regions are called meristems. What are they called? Meristems. Not meristematic. Remember, it is meristems. M-E-R-I-S-T-E-M-S, meristems. What is meristem? We know that growth in plants is restricted to special regions. Those special regions are what we call as meristems. This word meristems comes from a Greek word meristos, M-E-R-I-S-T-O-S, meristos. So the word meristem comes from a Greek word meristos, which means divided. So what is a meristematic tissue? It's an undifferentiated mass of cells. As in the beginning we did, that tissue is what? It's a group of cells. It is a mass of cells. But when we are specifying that the tissue is meristematic, we need to remember this meristematic tissue is a mass of cells and all the cells are undifferentiated. Okay? Undifferentiated, they have not yet acquired a specific shape or a function. What is a meristematic tissue? It is an undifferentiated mass of cells which retains its power of continuous division. Those cells which have the power of continuous division, which can continue to divide and have not yet differentiated, they together collectively form a meristematic tissue. What are the characteristics of meristematic tissue? Number one, they are living. Remember, whenever we talk about meristematic tissue characteristics, the first thing that you need to remember is that they are living. Second, they contain undifferentiated mass of continuously dividing cells. Meristematic tissue consists of cells, and how are the cells? They are undifferentiated mass and they are continuously dividing. Third one, the cells are compactly packed and there are no intercellular spaces. In a meristematic tissue, all the cells are very compactly packed to each other, very close to each other, and there are no intercellular spaces. Next point, the cells are connected by plasmodesmata. I think now you know what is plasmodesmata. Cytoplasmic connection between two adjacent cells is what we call as plasmodesmata. So all the cells in a meristematic tissue, they are connected to each other by plasmodesmata. And next, the nucleus is large. It is mainly present in the interface. If you remember the cell division process, so what about the nucleus? Nucleus is large and you will find it present in mid-stage interface. The last point we should know about meristematic tissue is that the cell wall is very thin and we call it as the primary wall. It is made up of cellulose. Very thin cell wall made up of cellulose generally called as the primary wall. A very fast revision of the characteristics of meristematic tissue. All the cells are living. Number two, the meristematic tissue contains undifferentiated mass of continuously dividing cells. Third, cells are compactly packed. There are no intercellular spaces. Fourth, cells are connected by plasmodesmata. Fifth, the nucleus is large. And sixth, the cell wall is thin. It is also known as the primary wall. And the cell wall is made up of what? It is made up of cellulose. Let us move on to the next topic, That is classification of meristems. Now we already know what are meristems, so let us classify the meristems. The meristems can be classified on the basis of three parameters or three bases you can have for classifying them. First is function, second is position, and the third is origin. On three bases you can classify meristems. What are the three bases? Function, position, and origin. In this video, I'll be taking up function and origin. In the next video, we will discuss classification of meristems on the basis of position. Now, let's start with classification of meristems on the basis of function. First thing that we are doing is, we are going to classify meristems. And what is going to be the basis of our classification first? We are going to classify them on the basis of function. Classification of meristems on the basis of function. The first type of meristem on the basis of function is protoderm. P-R-O-T-O, proto, D-E-R-M, protoderm. The outermost portion of the primary meristem, which you will find at the apex of the stem and the roots. See, the protoderm is the outermost portion of the primary meristem. Where will you find protoderm? It is found at the apex of the stem and the apex of the root. What is its function? It develops into epidermis. So we are classifying meristems on the basis of function. So protoderm will develop into epidermis. What will protoderm do? The protoderm will develop. The first meristem on the basis of what function is protoderm. And what is its function? It will develop into epidermis. This is the main function of protoderm, that it will develop into epidermis. And it is the outermost portion. You will find it at the apex of the stem and the root. The second one is procambium. P-R-O-C-A-M-B-I-U-M, procambium. What is the function of procambium? They develop into primary vascular tissues. You know what are vascular tissues. So the procambium will form the primary vascular tissues. Just as protoderm developed into epidermis, the procambium will develop into vascular tissues. And the third and the last kind of meristem on the basis of function is ground meristem. What is it? Ground meristem. What will this do? What is the function of ground meristem? This will develop into the ground tissue. This will develop into the ground tissue. Okay? The cells of ground meristem, they are thin-walled, they are living, and they are isodiametric. Isodiametric, all the cells almost have the same diameter. That means they are roughly spherical in size with equal size almost. Diameter is almost the same. We are talking about the cells of ground meristem beta. They are thin-walled, they are living, they are isodiametric. In later stages of growth, we are talking about once they become mature, they get differentiated into the ground meristem will form what? It will form the hypodermis, the cortex, the endodermis, the pericycle, and the pith. Almost all the things are formed from this, the last one, that is ground meristem. What all are formed? Hypodermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle, and pith. Let us very fast revise again. We have classified meristem on the basis of functions. On the basis of what? Function. The first was protoderm, which will develop into epidermis. The second is procambium, which will develop into vascular tissues. And the third is ground meristem, which will form hypodermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle, and pith. Now let us classify meristems on the basis of origin. Okay, beta? We have two kinds of meristems on the basis of origin. First is primary meristems. Those meristems which are derived during early embryonic stages. The meristems which grow are the meristems which are derived during early stages, that is the embryo stage. What are these meristems known as? They are known as primary meristems. They divide very fast, they divide rapidly, they differentiate, and these primary meristems later form the primary permanent tissues. It is these primary meristems which later, after differentiation, become what? They become primary permanent tissue. And where are they found? You will mainly find them in the growing apical regions of the root and the shoot. Where are they found, primary meristems? Growing apical regions of root and shoot. Understand once again, primary meristem, the word primary tells you initial stages. That means it grows or originates in the embryonic stage. Second feature about primary meristem that we need to remember, they divide very quickly. And once they differentiate, these primary meristems are converted into primary permanent tissue. We know that meristematic tissue, once they stop dividing and they differentiate themselves and take up a function, they convert into permanent tissues. Is it okay, Mina? When a meristematic tissue stops dividing, takes up a fixed shape, takes up a fixed function, then it gets differentiated. This process is for differentiation, and then we call it as a permanent tissue. So this primary meristem also, once they get differentiated, they convert into what we call as the primary permanent tissue, because meristems are converted into permanent tissue. Which meristem? Primary meristem. So which permanent tissue? Primary permanent tissue. Second one is the secondary meristem. They appear in the later stages in the development of a plant. Like your primary meristems were derived at the early embryonic stages, secondary meristems, they appear in the later stages in the development of a plant. Is it okay? Sometimes the primary permanent tissues also get the power of division and they become meristematic. See, it becomes reverse. I told you the primary meristems are converted into primary permanent tissues. But sometimes these primary permanent tissues again get the power of division and they again go back and become what in nature? Meristematic in nature. Clear? First they were primary meristems. They got differentiated, they converted into primary permanent tissues. But sometimes these primary permanent tissues again get back the power of division and they become meristematic again. As per the need of the plants, they can get differentiated into secondary meristems. See, it depends now. If there is a need of the plant, this can happen. That the primary meristem first converts into a primary permanent tissue, and then this primary permanent tissue can get back and become meristematic tissue, or it can convert into secondary meristematic tissue. Anything can happen. Either primary permanent into secondary permanent meristem tissue, or the primary meristematic can go back and convert to what? Meristematic. This all depends upon the need of the plant. If you're getting confused, listen again. All depends upon the need of a plant. Once your primary meristem has converted into primary permanent tissue, two things can happen with the primary permanent tissue. Either the primary permanent tissue will grow, mature and become the secondary permanent tissue, or it will get back the power of division and go back and again become what? Meristematic. Some examples of secondary meristems, what do you call them as? Secondary meristematic tissue. We are calling about those tissues which appear in the later stages of a plant, secondary meristems. Examples of coccambium and interfascicular cambium. Coccambium, you know. Let me tell you about interfascicular cambium. I-N-T-E-R, inter. F-A-S-I-C-U-L-A-R, interfascicular cambium. This is the cambium found between two vascular bundles. The cambium which is found between two vascular bundles is known as what? It is known as the interfascicular cambium. So very fast revision of what we have done. First we revised tissue. Group of cells, common origin, same function. A plant body has many types of tissues, but we've already classified them into two tissues, meristematic and permanent. We are only dealing with meristematic as of now. We know that growth in plants is restricted to only special regions, and these special regions are called meristems. The word meristems comes from a Greek word meristos, which means divided. Meristematic tissue is an undifferentiated mass of cells which has the power of continuous division. When we did characteristics of meristematic tissue, we said they are living. They contain undifferentiated mass of continuously dividing cells. The cells are compactly packed, that means there are no intercellular spaces. Cells are connected by plasmodesmata. Nucleus is large, it is present in the interphase stage. And lastly, the cell wall is thin, it is made up of cellulose. Then we said there are three bases on which we can classify meristem's function, position and origin. First, we classified the meristem on the basis of function. The first one was protoderm. The function of protoderm was to develop into epidermis. The second was procambium. See how we remember PPI. Okay, first, I'll tell you a simple way of remembering later. First, listen to this. What is the first one? Protoderm. Protoderm will develop into epidermis. Second is your procambium, which will form vascular tissue. And the third is your ground meristem, which forms the hypodermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle and pith. So, when we are classifying meristems on the basis of function, you can simply learn a formula PPG. What is the formula? PPG. P for protoderm, P for procambium and G for ground meristems. So, you got three kinds of meristems, PPG, on the basis of function. It's easy for you to remember. On the basis of function, meristems are of three types. What are the three types? PPG. You can make a simple formula for yourself. PPG, P protoderm, which converts to epidermis, procambium, which converts to vascular tissue, and the last one is your ground meristem. Then we classify them on the basis of origin. This is very simple. There is no need to make a formula. We have two kinds of meristem on the basis of origin: primary meristem and secondary meristems. Those meristems which are derived during early embryonic stages are primary meristems, and those which develop later in the growth stages of a plant, they are secondary meristems. These primary meristematic tissues divide very rapidly, and once they differentiate themselves, these primary meristems are converted into primary permanent tissues. When we discussed about secondary meristems, we said that they lie in both stem and roots, and sometimes the primary permanent tissue again acquires a power of division and it becomes meristematic. It all depends upon the need of the plant. We did some examples of meristems: cock cambium, interfascicular cambium. Interfascicular cambium, maybe this is a new word for you. Interfascicular, interfascicular, interfascicular cambium means the cambium between two vascular bundles. So this is all about classification of meristem on the basis of function, PPG, and on the basis of origin, primary meristem and secondary meristem. In the next video, we will try to classify meristem on the basis of their position.